Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily DVAR Halacha. And here's a brand new halacha for you. And it's for Tuesday, the 28th day of November, the 10th day of Kislev. Here we go. Just want to finish up the unit that we were doing about shoes and a couple more laws about that. The Gemara in Baba Basra, if you want to know where, that's on Daf Nun Ches 58, says that you're not supposed to put shoes under a bed. However, most of the poskim say that we don't follow that law anymore today and that it is okay to keep shoes under your bed. So you're good with that. The Gemara in Yuma says that sleeping while your shoes are on, that's a taste of death, and a person should not involve himself in such a custom. Don't go to sleep with your shoes on. Others say that it causes forgetfulness, especially of your Torah learning, and so therefore you should never sleep with your shoes on. Even young children should be encouraged to take their shoes off when they go to sleep. If your kid falls asleep with their shoes on, then it would be a good idea to take them off. The Kaf HaChaim says that the same thing applies also to sandals and slippers. Don't go to sleep with your sandals and or slippers on. If you're taking a short nap, or you're traveling and you're sitting on an airplane and your shoes are on, that kind of situation, rabbis argue about that. Some say it's fine, some say it's not fine. But if you do take a full nap on a bed, for sure your shoes should be taken off. You know we have a custom, you may know that we have a custom, not to put on two garments at the same time. Like, for example, a shirt and a sweater that were just bunched together and you just put your arms in the, you know, in the shirt sleeves and sweater sleeves at the same time and get it on like that. It's not supposed to be proper to do that. So the question arises, what about if you have your shoes encased in outer boots or rubbers that cover them or things like that? Is that okay? Can you just pop them on together? And the Aruch HaShulchan says that that's fine because shoes are not exactly a garment. They act kind of differently. Another little bit of a different topic, but still on our interesting unit about shoes. Rain shoes have no problem of, you know, men are not supposed to put on ladies' clothing, and ladies are not supposed to put on men's clothing. So if you borrow your wife's or your girlfriend's rain shoes, is that a problem? And to that, the halacha says, no, it's not a problem. Those are just outer gear. They're not really so much considered clothing. So it's fine. You could borrow someone's of the opposite gender, their rain shoes or things of the sort. And Sefer Hasidim says, lastly, if someone dies, it's not a good idea for you to put on their shoes, an improper activity. Thanks for logging on, and log on again tomorrow for more. Bye-bye.